Is Mena Trott ready to tell a story?
Okay, first, I'm not drunk. I'm just really, really nervous, and I'm like on the verge of passing out, so please bear with me. Okay. When my dad was a kid, he locked himself in an accordion case. My grandma played the accordion, and so it was lying around the house. And somehow my dad managed to find it, open it, get in it, and lock himself in. That's my dad. And this is his story. He loves this story. This is his childhood story, being a klutz, being stupid, being just completely bizarre. I mean, one thing, you have an accordion case lying around the house, so you know something's going on that's not right. And then for this to happen. So this is my dad's story, and I always wanted a story to be as equally good, as equally horrible, and just kind of pathetic. So I finally got my story in 1987. I was 10 years old, and we were at a Walden bookstore. And I'm sure you're all familiar with Walden bookstores, the mall stores, you know, the just the banality of everything. And so we're in it, and my dad, besides being dysfunctional from locking himself in the case, he also goes by the name of Junior. And, you know, that's funny and everything on TV shows, you know, Uncle Junior from The Sopranos, it's cute. But for a 40-year-old man, it's just kind of pathetic. So this is Junior. And so we're at the bookstore, and my dad has wandered off like he always does, just doing whatever he's doing. And my mom's paying, because my dad usually just hands her his book, says, go pay for this, and she has to do the work. So she's doing that, and I'm just kind of wandering off too. And two side notes. First of all, I had these pair of white little go-go boots. And this is, I'm 10 years old, and this is 87, and I don't remember go-go boots being really popular there then, so that's kind of just interesting. So I have these boots, they've got everything on them. They've got rhinestones, they've got fringes, they're just horrible. And I'm wearing them with a little jean skirt, I can remember everything. So I'm off, and this is also the summer of gymnastics. I was taking gymnastics. Since this is the summer of gymnastics, everywhere I go, I decide I'm going to start doing something. And so I'm standing by a bookcase, actually it's a tape case, which is about this big, and I'm probably, how tall are you when you're 10? That big? Okay, about this big. So it's taller than me, and it has all the cassette tapes. You know, the classic rock, the classical, nothing you really want to listen to, just the things that just somehow got sent to a Walden Books. So I'm standing by this bookcase, and I'm doing basically, you know, the universal splits position where you always want to do it. So I start slipping, and I'm not going to do it because I'm going to start slipping. And the first thing I grab for is this tape thing. So I'm holding it, and I'm just slipping, 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 and it falls. It falls on top of me, completely covers me. All the tapes are on the ground. I'm lying on the ground. The thing is covering my head. You can't see anything but my white boots. So this is out of the Wizard of Oz. It's so horribly bizarre. But no one can see the boots yet. This is the thing. So the tape decks are there. And when this tape thing was coming over me, you know, they say you black out. I blacked out. I was just like, what's happening? Please don't let this happen. So I'm on the ground. I'm like, I'm not getting up. I'm going to just pretend I'm dead. Because if I pretend I'm dead, people won't be mad at me for dropping the tapes. People won't care what happened to me. They're just going to say, oh, God, she's dead. Let's be nice to her. So I'm doing this, just laying there. And it's silent. Everybody's kind of looking at it. And then all of a sudden I hear, oh, my God, Junior, it's Mena. It's my mom, and she's yelling to my dad at the back of the store. See, she didn't care before. It was just kind of sad until she saw the boots. And then she knew, oh, God, I've got to start really acting interested in it because this is my child. So I get up, and my dad runs in. He's actually being really involved, and he lifts up the thing, and he helps me out. He carries me out. And God, it's so dramatic. It's really beautiful. And And I'm just so embarrassed. And the clerk goes, we were supposed to get that tied last week, like tied to the wall. And my dad kind of didn't really have a response. And you think that they'd be so worried about lawsuits that they'd say, you know, they'd have you sign things or something. They didn't do anything. And so we got out there outside of the mall, and we were sitting by the escalator. And I'm telling my dad, you know, we could have at least got a gift certificate out of that. I can't believe that. And we didn't get a gift certificate, but I finally got my story. So.